looking at mobility aids and thinking about the future and where I wanted things like this to go, I definitely started looking at how mobility aids are presented in media, and a lot has changed in recent years towards technology specifically. So a lot of these devices have become a lot more high-tech than how they used to be even 10, 20 years ago. And this is a question I wanted to ask myself. So where are we going with mobility devices? What's the future for disabled people? And this is in the show The 100. There's this character called Raven, and she wears this leg brace, but it's set 100 years in the future. So this is an idea into what the creators of that show thought mobility, where they thought mobility aids were going. So it's quite, it looks quite technical. It's got a lot of wires going off of it. Now obviously this is a show, so it doesn't have an actual practical function because the actress is able-bodied, but it does show the sort of ideological progression of where people think, at least aesthetically, mobility aids are going. Now it's a bit rough around the edges, it looks quite chunky, it's very evident, it's very obvious, but it is an indication of what can be done. These are notes that I made from a TED talk that I listened to from a woman who is a double amputee, and she brought up ideas of where disability is going and the future of disability and how people are going to view disabled people in the future. And things that I took from this were phrases like the architects of their own identities, relating to disabled people being able to choose how they present themselves, having their autonomy returned to them and not taken away from them, designing their bodies from a place of empowerment. Again, this is going towards being in control of yourself and being able to do the best by yourself. And from that, I started looking at specifically the future of disability and how this could lead to augmentation. Because why stop at normal functioning? Why, if you have the possibility of not just replacing what you've lost, but enhancing it, would you not take that? So I wanted to look at this in more detail. Some of the notes that I've put down are things like flight, speed, growth, strength, light, movement, sound, magnetism, things like this that you often associate with superheroes. Why can't we make this a reality? I had a discussion with Jen, the leader, and we worked on an action plan for the next stage of my project. We went through my book and I've figured out what I needed to do, so I need to ask myself more questions, keep all my titles and numbers going, and work on more things like sketches and plans, and really get into the practical side of working now and stuff like that. This is a final concept map, so taking the light glass concrete leg braces and movement that I want to look at and working ways between them, figuring out different linking phrases and showing my thought process between these five things. Finally, the last little thing is the peer crit I did with Ruby. She's on the fashion course, so she has a totally different way of thinking about the ideas that I could make and my ideas for what she could make. I've never worked in a fashion setting, so it was very refreshing and interesting to look at her perspective. And some of the things that I'm looking at do overlap with what she's looking at, especially in the mobility aid fashion pathway sort of thing. Is that there are some fashion industries and designers that have had disabled people walk on their catwalks and stuff. And I wanted to look at how that has happened, what sort of things led up to that discussion, and some of the social backlash from it.